Is that why you've come? To end the Avengers?
I've come to save the world. But also... yeah.
Look, I realize it was another movie. All I'm saying is every time that Quicksilver and Scarlet Witch were on the screen, I kept expecting Godzilla to come out and start chasing them. Oh, hello, my name is Fu Manchu. Well, speaking of Scarlet Witch and Quicksilver, and we will not mention the Godzilla again, yeah, a lot of you have asked me if I've seen Age of Ultron Avengers 2. Well, I did. On Sunday, I went to see it, so let's go over here to the FUBAR and talk about it for a second. Well, there's not a lot to say. I liked it. Okay, that's all. Anyway, it was a really good movie, and I really liked it. Okay, let's seriously go back. Yeah, I really liked it a lot. I thought it was really good. I think all the actors did really good and stuff like that. They changed a few things here and there, but, you know, little things. You know, Quicksilver and Scarlet Witch were a little different, but that's okay. I really liked the posts. No, wait, it's not post. It was, like, during the credits scene. I really liked that one a lot. I was, like, freaking out. I was like, ah! But it was, like, really quick. So then I thought there would be something else at the very end of the credits, but there wasn't. There wasn't anything there. But I hope you saw the middle credits one, because it was really good. Now, a lot of people in the theater that I was at, they were leaving. I'm sitting there, and I'm watching them go, and I'm like, hey, you know there's gonna be something at the end, don't you? But they just left. So they missed it. I thought it was really good. I liked it. But, yeah, the movie was really good, everybody. So if you haven't seen it, go see it. And if you don't want to see it, go see it anyways, because everybody else will like it, too. So so go give it a chance, man. Jeez. But anyway, today's review will be on something directly related to it. So are you ready? Okay. Let's go see what's over there to be reviewed. Today's review will be on the Art Asylum and Diamond Select Toys. Oh, boy. Avengers Minimates. There's a lot of stuff to say here. Avengers Minimates. That's right, the little ones. And it says, includes bonus parts. Oh, good. Like what? Do they include an Iron Man for free? Probably not. But look at them all up there. That's pretty cool. It makes me want to say, Avengers, and then quit the movie. But anyway, there you go. You will see the Age of Ultron, Quicksilver, and Age of Ultron, Scarlet Witch. Now, these are a Toys R Us exclusive, as indicated by the R little sticker there. And, yeah, when I saw these, I had to have them. I thought they were cute. I bought them a few weeks ago, and I just haven't reviewed them yet. But I just think they look neat. I wish they'd come out with some Marvel Legends versions of these guys, and I guarantee you they will. It's just, they're making us wait. But anyway, there's the front of the package looking very cool indeed. Now I say we look at the back of the package. What do you say? Look out, Hulk! So here's the back of the package, and you'll see everyone in this wave, which it isn't the whole, you know, all of the characters from the movie, but I'm assuming there'll be another wave of these. Come on, they always do that. They're not gonna leave out some of those characters. But anyway, there you'll see Scarlet Witch and Quicksilver, and then Iron Man and Black Widow and Captain America and Thor. Looking very cool indeed. And in the middle there it says mix and match parts. Okay, I understand that, but why would you want to? I have never seen, these little mini-mates say that before. Mix and match parts? Why? I mean, maybe the accessories you can give, like, you know, Thor's hammer to Iron Man, but he can't pick it up, and then you could give his shield to, like, Black Widow, and she's like, what am I supposed to do with this? But, yeah, why would you want to mix and match parts? I don't know. Maybe they mean, like, you know, taking their masks off and stuff and having their hair. Because I know that Captain America and Iron Man do that, but Thor and Black Widow, do they have mix and match parts? But anyway, there's a little bio down there, and it says, Pietro Maximoff possesses the ability to move at extremely high speeds. The source of his powers, as well as his connection to Hydra and Ultron, is unknown at this time. No, he's a mutant. We know that. But, let's see. Wanda Maximoff is Pietro's, sister and can manipulate magical energies. Her abilities include telekinesis and hypnosis. The source of these powers is unknown at this time. They're mutants! Jeez, I don't care how many times you reboot the comics, they're mutants, so let it go, people. But anyway, there's the back of the package looking very awesome indeed, so let's look at the front of the package one more time. So here's the front of the package for the very last time, and I say we waste no more time and open it! So here's the brother and sister duo looking very cute as buttons. They are super cute. Oh my goodness, they couldn't get any cuter than this. But anyway, there they are, straight from Age of Ultron, looking very mini-matey, and I think they look awesome indeed. Now you're probably saying, hey, what did they come with? Well, hey, Quicksilver, why don't you show them what they came with? Does he do that often? I'm assuming he does. Okay, let's see what they came with, shall we? They came with these little googly eye bases, which I like that the Minimates have been including these recently. I think that's very awesome indeed. And they also came with this little fold-out brochure thing, and when you unfold it, you get a really cool poster. It's really neat. It's really little, but it's still cool. And it's got a little advertisement over here for some all-new X-Men. Looking very cool. I like his big old feet on Beast there. That's pretty cute. But anyway, and you flip it over, and it looks like this. Here's a little comic starring Spider-Man, Iron Man, Thor, and who else do we got there? Daredevil and Stiltman. Okay, that's pretty cool. And then over here it's got an advertisement for the Days of Future Past X-Men, which I've never seen this set before. I don't know where they are. I really like that Wolverine up there in the leather jacket. Dang it, I would like to have that, but I haven't seen it before. Okay, let's look at the figure some more, shall we? Hello, Wolverine! Now, although Quicksilver also came with a little googly-eyed base, he doesn't need it because he has the little running base, which is awesome looking. Check that out. Little running effect, little dust cloud. And I do wish that Scarlet Witch there would have came with like some little red energy or something to put around her hands, but that's okay. And neither one of them have the little secret Lego faces behind their hair, which kind of stinks, but because they could totally do that and hide them behind their hair, but they didn't this time. But anyway, there they are looking very cool. Let's look at them from behind. So here they are from behind, looking kind of plain, but that's pretty much what their outfits look like. That's pretty cool, though. They look awesome. Now, Scarlet Witch's head doesn't turn very well because of that thick thing of hair there. But other than that, I mean, they have the same sort of articulation as any other mini-mate. And I think that is very cool indeed. Now, before we close, let's look at them super-duper close-up. Check this out. Now, I don't know how well you'll be able to make everything out, but check it out. Look, they even give him his little sleeve gloves, his little hipster sleeve gloves. But there's his legs looking very cool. You can make out some of the paint there. I had to put him on the normal base. Look how big his feet look this way. And let's see here. Let's go up to his face. Oh, my goodness. They did such a good job on these little faces. I mean, they've been making these little simplistic no-nose faces work for so long. Every time you see one, you know exactly who it is. Go over here to Scarlet Witch. Look at all the details they gave her there. She's got, like, little necklaces and stuff like that. I like the little stitching on her lapel there. That's pretty cool. And then there's her face looking very cool. She has that worried, I hope Godzilla doesn't chase us look on her face. And then down here you got her hands. And then, let's see, does she have rings? Yeah, she's actually got rings. They did a good job. I didn't even notice that. That's cool. I'll have to turn her and look at the other hand. And then there's her little socks or boots or whatever those are. Looking very cool indeed. Holy cow, that's awesome. And yes, not only does she have rings, but she actually has bracelets on her hands. That is awesome. And little zippers on her jacket there. Look at that. Little paint details like that just make it look so cool. And it's the same on the other hand, too. That is so neat that they did that. I mean, because they didn't need to do that at all. Check it out. I like the little details that they had like that. Didn't know he had a tattoo on his butt, but that's okay. There you go. That's pretty awesome. So there's my very quick and simple review of the Art Asylum Diamond Select. Oh, God, that's a lot of stuff to say, I'm telling you. Age of Ultron, Minimates of Scarlet Witch and Quicksilver. And they look awesome. And I'm really happy with these little figures. They look so cute indeed. And like I said, they're Toys R Us exclusive. So if you're looking for them, look for them there. And you'll find them because they're not very hard to find at all. So until next time, I guess I'll have to do it myself. Post-credit scene. Foo reviews! Come on, Felzbug! You know, I still can't believe that when we went to order popcorn at the movie theater, you had to request a bucket full of Transformers. I know you eat them at home, but for crying out loud, Felzbug!